and welcome to the American Rancher. I'm Pam Minnick. A strong attribute for any beef cattle breed is flexibility. This week, we'll see Braunvieh cattle at work on ranches in several states. These operations use Braunvieh cattle for the breed's impressive sire traits, as well as its versatility in a crossbreeding program. Braunvieh excel with hybrid vigor, high performance, and are ideal for cattlemen retaining ownership from the pasture to the rail.
Hi, my name's Tyler Lister. My wife and I, Crystal, we bought this place here just not too long ago. Brought the Braunvieh bloodline in here last year. Mr. John Harper, who works with us hand in hand, day in, day out on this ranch. I am new to the breed, but we are located just outside of Lindsay, Oklahoma. Hands down, the cattle that were on the property when we got here, the difference that you could tell just at a glance with what was bred with the other black breed that was here versus the Braunvieh bulls, certainly noticeable right off the bat. Heavier built calves, you know, back end, big heavy bone structures, just a good looking solid calf on the ground when we got here. You know, our goal here is to continue that and grow that on the ranch as we have it set up to right now for next year's calf crop. John has done a tremendous job taking care of the property, especially the cattle, with what he's done.
We've been running Angus and Angus cross cows most of our life, and they've done well, but we wanted something that would put a little more size, bone structure in these calves, and get some docility in these cattle that make them a little easier to handle. And I seen an advertisement on RFD. Guy had some Braunvieh bulls, and I thought I'd go look into it. Went out there to gather the bulls up or look at them. We go to the first pasture. He says, "Oh, I ain't got a corral over here, but if you want one of these bulls, we'll just back trailer up in the corner." We back trailer up in the corner. The bulls stand there. We get out of the pickup, load him in the trailer. We go to the next pasture, the same deal. There's no corrals there. Cows are all up around, or the bulls are up there in that corner. We just back it up, get in the fence, open the gate, pick out which one we want, drive them in the trailer. How many places are you gonna go do that? That speaks volumes to me when you go to handling these cattle, what you can do with them. And it, to me, it's hands down, a win-win.
You know, bringing the kids out here is something that we've talked about for a long time. We've never, you know, had the opportunity to purchase a property like we have now. And, you know, God's timing just planned out the way that it should. And here we are. And it seems as though they're pretty gentle. And that makes me feel a little bit better because, you know, my daughter, she's 9 and she's little. And you worry about that. But she hops right up there and she does what she needs to do. You know, my son, he's in there, you know, getting it done too. And it's as a mother, I'm good with it. I don't fear it for them. So
good. They're so gentle, you know. I mean, easy to handle. It is, you know, anybody can handle them. And that, you know, the elite, you know, when what gets me is the, and I had to explain to people, a lot of them, when they're first born, they look kind of like a little jackrabbit. In 3 days, they look like a linebacker. I mean, you know, they'll nurse a mama cow's brains out. So, you know, you definitely want one that can produce some milk because they're going to go after it. I've always had real good luck with them. My first encounter with Braunvieh was approximately 20 years ago. What I was always impressed with on these Braunvieh bulls is when you turn them out, they know what their job is.
We've had some hot days here lately, and they're still out with the cows doing their job. They're not shaded up.
You know, the F1 cross here, to me, you know, you look at the total package, you know, I mean, we're ranchers. It's all about profitability, right? And presenting a good product at the end of the line. I mean, that's what we have to do.
And you follow them, and that's what they are. I mean, you know, they're carcass cattle.
you'll see that bone structure immediately. You know there's some growth potential when the day they're born, and 2 weeks later they're already bounced up, ready to going on, you know.
Back to profitability, you know, with the milk capability of the Braunvieh cow, there again, that calf hits the ground, we're putting weight on, right? Our weaning weights are going to be higher.
The F1 cross heifers are going to milk. That's one thing these Braunvies will do. They will milk, and the data I've seen on their milk fat test, their milk fat percentage in that milk is more than any other breed. That's why these calves grow so good.
My kids have missed what I got to grow up in. And now that I've kind of accomplished one hurdle here, we've decided to come back, come to the country, and get back into it. I want my kids to experience growing up like I did, right? It's peaceful, it's hard work, but there's something at the end of it, and that's something they need to see and learn.
After the break,
we have decided to go on the cow side and go with Braunvieh cows and put the Gelvie bulls on them and go more on what the Braunvieh cow has to offer.
Braunvieh females earn their keep and then some. That story is next here on The American Rancher. Welcome back to The American Rancher. Braunvieh females are well known for longevity and fertility. Their ability to put more calves on the ground during their lifetime certainly translates into more profit. But the real performance originates from the Braunvieh influence in those calves.
We're here in Saltillo, Texas. We have about 331 acres here that we run. We run close to 100 head of cows. I would say 75% of them are Braunvieh. We got into the Braunvieh about 7 or 8 years ago, come from a commercial background. Me and my wife happened to be sitting watching American Rancher one night, and we saw the Braunvieh episode, and my wife thought they were cool. We didn't know anything about them, and come to find out, a friend of ours, we went to church with him, and his ad came up, and we thought, hey, we know him, you know, and so that next Sunday at church, he said, hey, we saw you on TV, and hey, what about your cattle, you know, and he got to telling us about him. He said, come out and check them out and come look at our heifers. And so we went out a couple weeks later and walked through his heifers and liked them. And he said, man, they're gentle, they're good for kids. And he went on. And we thought, well, we'll buy four heifers for the kids and see, four turned into 10. And as we went on through the year, we went to Fort Worth and bought some out of there and just got to really liking the breed and what the cows were. And now, 8 years later, here we are, and we've been really happy with them. With my family being in the Gelvie business, we have decided to go on the cow side and go with Braunvieh cows and put the Gelvie bulls on them and go more on what the Braunvieh cow has to offer, the milk, and the mothering instincts and how they raise a calf, the longevity, how early the heifers breed. We just feel that we can isolate our cattle that way and have consistency. That's been the biggest thing for us, is consistency on that end of it. We know what the Braunvieh cow will do, and we also, crossing it on the Gelvie bulls, we know what that cross will do as far as finish, and we feel like those calves are big feeders in the commercial end of it. We know that they do well. Our buyers really like them. We have a deal set up now to where we've put our cattle out there enough through the commercial buyers that they know what our cattle are going to be and what our calves are going to be, and the consistency of it, that we don't have any issue selling our calves. They like our calves, they like to feed our calves, and so it's been a great process for us, seeing what these Braunvieh cows will do cross with these Gelby bulls. Being in East Texas, we have a lot of humidity. Of course, we have a lot of different climates, and so they see everything from extreme heat to extreme cold, and they do real well on that. I mean, there's times, I mean, just like behind us right now, it's 95 degrees and the sun's shining in the evening, and they're out grazing, and that's a big thing. They're not shaded up. And these calves being turned out here on these cows on grass, you know, our feed program is this grass. We do cake a little bit, just enough to supplement them, but for the most part, they're out here and they're building their pounds off of their mom. And we also believe that with the Gelbys and the Braunvies, they're very closely related on the carcass grades. And I believe that's what you're gonna see more and more of, that these cattle produce extremely well on the knife. The carcass values are high on both of them. And by combining that, I believe that your values will be extremely high. I believe on the choice, you'll start seeing more and more of that at the packing plants and at your meat markets and things like that. I believe it's kind of the future of these cattle, I really do. I think that taking them all the way through is gonna be something that we will see more and more of here in the future. And I hope to, because the values are there. I mean, they're just continually gonna get better. And I believe with the Braunvies, whichever way you go on the F1 cross, whether it be a bull on a set of commercial cows or a set of cows on a commercial bull or an F1 cross of some sort, the Braunvieh works either way. It's for the commercial man, I think the Braunvies are the best all-around cow that there is.
Up next.
The Braunvieh Angus cross provides the best of both worlds. Just look how many carcass contests purebred Braunvieh have won. You have the best product you can give a customer.
Adaptability and outstanding profit traits are putting high-grading carcasses on the rail. That story's right after the break here on The American Rancher. Welcome back to The American Rancher. For decades, Braunvieh has been the breed of choice for cow-calf producers nationwide. Coupled with the outstanding profit traits of Braunvieh-influenced females, adaptability across all breeds makes the Braunvieh bull the ideal profit driver.
You know, a question I get all the time is, Braunvieh, one, what is Braunvieh? So you have to explain that to them, and two, why? So they say on average it takes 21 years for a new idea, new breed, new seed, new whatever, take a hold in the industry. So it's just like a lot of people, you know, one ear out the other. Call around, most of my friends were mainly Angus. I talked to one guy, and a friend of a friend was Dwight Oldie, which obviously he's familiar with the Oldie genetics, and we've got a whole lot of them. He'd be a cousin to Tim. At the time, he was working in the feedlot industry, and he's talking Braunvieh. He's talking about how good they gain, how good they yield, how good they grade. They can also qualify for non-hormonal export projects and programs. And I was kind of sold, and I started researching on my own. Besides the hybrid vigor, And somebody like that telling me that's in the feedlot business, seeing them day in, day out, groups of this breed, groups of this cross come in, how they gain, go to the packer, see what they grade, see what they yield. And that was his recommendation on exactly what I had. I was sold. As a beef producer, you know, I've had different thoughts of different breeds, but I've got a responsibility to the consumer to provide them with red meat in their freezer, right? And so yield grade, hanging weight, all that ties in together, and that's my goal and my responsibility to provide you with more good quality meat from the hanging weight.
Being a former coach, I want my beef to be the best. So when my customers buy beef off of me, I want them to turn around and say, that's the best beef.
You know, switch to a Braunvieh bull, talk to some folks, trying to improve yield grades, our grass-fed operation, trying to get over 60% on grass kind of hard. You know, anything you can do to gain an extra buck, you know, the way I calculate it, you know, it's another 4% yield grade is about $150. So some of the experts I talked to kind of recommended me towards Braunvieh. I knew a guy, started researching it, and it's one of the best decisions so far that we've made. Due to COVID, we haven't been able to kill anything yet, but some of the heifers and stuff, just run them in our traditional grass program alongside everything else, they've gained just as good or better than everything else has. Soggy calves is what we got. I mean, they're deep, thick, and compared to the Angus, you can tell that they just visually have more muscle, a little bit stronger, a little bit beefier, and that's what we're after is the beef. Owning that meat market in Oklahoma City, we see it firsthand, the amount of people that come in, and that's what they want. We've had visions of being able to have a book in there of different farmers. We're just not there yet, and this Braunvieh bull, it'll be part of that.
The bottom line for me, I want our customers, because we don't go to the sale barn, I want my customers to say, that's the best beef I've eaten. That's the biggest compliment we can have.
One breed doesn't do it all, and that hybrid vigor in the Braunvieh Angus cross provides the best of both worlds. There are other animals and other breeds that will provide some yield, but not like the Braunvieh without sacrificing the quality. I mean, just research it. Just look how many carcass contests just purebred Braunvieh have won. And what the Angus is known for, and you go to crossing those suckers, you have the best product you can give a customer.
There's several things that I look at within my herd, okay? Docility is very important to me, not just because I don't want to be ran over, but I have grandkids, and I also have a wife that I want to keep happy. And so I don't want, if an animal's going to have an attitude, I don't want them in my herd. If they're the last one in, I don't want them. If they won't go in the chute, I don't want them. And so far with all the Braunvies that we've had with our Angus, we've not had any issues like that. And that's important to me.
Hi, my name's Kason Wolf. I'm 12 years old. I'm in sixth grade. I run some cows with my grandpa and dad. I chose to put them on a Braunvieh bull because the babies are heavier, they're thicker, they seem more stout, and they seem to grow a lot faster. I help them rake and when they're doing hay and alfalfa. I help coach build a lot of fence and move cows around. I help them give shots, warm them, put them through the chute.
The other aspect of it is, as far as that, is can they gain on grass? Because they're not going to get any corn, they're not going to get any grain. Is if they can't gain out here and have that, what we call a barrel around their belly, you know, they won't work for us. And so I'm excited in the aspect that what we've been able to do with our Angus, and I know you've got to see our Angus cows and see how, lacking for a better word, how obese they are. That influence right there hasn't changed anything. So that part I love.
My favorite part of working cows is spending time with Coach and my dad and just helping them and getting paid.
That's all the time we have today. We hope you enjoyed the show. To learn more about the value of Braunvieh genetics, log on to braunvieh.org. And to find out more about us, visit our website, theamericanrancher.com, or connect with us on Facebook. I'm Pam Minnick. For the entire American Rancher team, thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.
Four Farms invites you to the Fall Bull Sale, October 23rd in Cameron, Texas. Over 550 registered pasture-raised Angus bulls are primed and ready to go to work. Backed by the rock-solid 44 Farms guarantee, these boys qualify for the Prime Pursuits partnership with Walmart. Bid live on Superior Click to Bid and watch on Dish Channel 997. Invest in performance with top Angus genetics. Log on 44 Farms or Superior Livestock for details.
Established in 1987, Superior Livestock Auction is the largest cattle marketing network in North America. We sell forward contracted, load lots of ranch fresh cattle on video and internet auctions. Last year, over 1.4 million head were sold by Superior Livestock Auction, and they brought top dollar. World champion auctioneers present your cattle to buyers across the nation. We have over 8,000 active and qualified buyers, maximizing competitive bidding and true price discovery. Your cattle stay at the ranch until delivery, and your Superior rep writes you a check when it's done. Simple as that. Our job is getting you the best paycheck possible. We know that most producers only get one paycheck a year for their cattle, and more cattlemen and women trust us to get the most out of every sale. Call us at 800-422-2117 or go online to learn more about how Superior Livestock Auction can work for you.